Obsession day two. We have among us a renowned speaker, Mr. Saril Roy, motivational speaker at Tata Cummins Jamshedpur. Sir is going to speak us on key, that is kindness, empathy, and you. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Saranjeet Kaur, right?
Yes, sir.
A very good morning to the participants, to all the Rotarians. This is my immense pleasure to communicate with you all on the digital platform. In fact, this is my second interaction with Raila. A couple of years back in Gulmohar School, there was one event of Raila where I had participated and shared my thoughts and all. So this is my second interaction with you all, and I am really, really very, very happy. Let me introduce myself first. I am Saril Roy. I work for Tata Cummins Limited. Beyond my profession, I work for Tata Cummins Limited. I have been working in different departments, including HR, where I was in the role of CR and training for a long period of time. I have an engagement with social initiatives with few organizations like Initiatives of Change, TSRDS, which is better known as TSF, Tata Steel Foundation these days, Voluntary Blood Donation Association, People for Change, and few other organizations. So in my almost 12 to 15 years of social engagement, one thing which has really connected me to my core of, to the core of my heart is kindness. Last day, yesterday's opening, I was following the opening session. I could hear Mr. Kamal Sanghvi, Mr. Himanshu Rai, and Mr. Rajendra Gadotra. Today, for some issues, I had some technical issues in while connecting, but yesterday there was no issue. So I could hear to these three gentlemen very, very correctly. So Mr. Kamal Sanghvi told was describing something about becoming a go-getter. Okay, the achiever in you. Mr. Rajan Gadotra very, very positively, very encouragingly shared about positivity, right? But one point I would like to mention, Mr. Himanshu Rai, if you recall the conversation, he mentioned one important thing, that was emotional intelligence, right? Very important. We will be talking on emotional intelligence today. These are very difficult days. I am sure that all the participants out here might have experienced real tough times in last 2-3 months. Am I right? So, am I audible to everybody? Let me ask.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. So, the COVID-19 period, locked up at home, can't go anywhere. The students who are students, they cannot go to school, cannot go, go and meet up their friend, and so on and so forth. We also see sufferings around. Sufferings? I mean, the infection and death is there, but sufferings on the road. The migrant labors, hunger, poverty, we are packed up with so many not so good news, right? But there are some positivity as well. There were so many hands. There were so many hands which came up for supporting all those who were suffering, right? Very difficult times, but there were so many people who felt that instinct in their heart to come up and help people. Okay, this is very important. In fact, what I believe is the COVID-19 has given us a break to the entire human community, the entire human world, to think back and sit and think. Where are we going wrong? think how the human behavior has changed, how we as human being are behaving. Have you ever thought that? So my talk will be all about this. I would request Abhishek, can you just pop up the first slide? Abhishek, are you there? Yeah. So much. Thank you so much, Abhishek. So prompt. So I have written one sentence out there. Anyone can live an inspiring life. Let us think, are we living an inspiring life? Many a times, inspiring life is confused with influencing life. Influencing life at times is very, very dominant. I have power, I have intelligence, I have money, I can influence others. But for inspiring, what do you need? To inspire, you need an example. So we will talk about inspiring life. Next slide, please. As I told you, that inspiring life need not be, you need not be highly educated, you need not be you need not be highly educated, you need not be on very high position, not very powerful, not very rich, or you also need not have many followers. Just what you need to is that listen to that tiny little voice within. I would request Abhishek to just run the clip. Thank you, Abhishek. In a small video clip of 1.5 minutes, what did we see? We saw few people who were common men. They were common men before they started taking initiative. They became famous. They led people. They were all common men. But what was common in them? One thing common in all these common men was the compassion, the kindness, karuna. In Hindi, you say it karuna. This was one thing which was common in all these common men. And another thing which was common in all these common men was they listened to their inner voice. And somebody stood before the military tank, somebody got us freedom, somebody helped the poor and the sufferings, so on and so forth. So anybody, I repeat, anybody, any common person, any simple person can bring a larger change. You need not to be powerful. You need not to be rich. You need not to be highly qualified to bring in change. what you need to do is listen to your inner voice and take that one little step. Here, we will be talking about that one little step, one little inner voice, that is kindness. Okay? Next slide, please, Abhishek. I start with a small story of Margaret Mead. Many people might have heard about Margaret Mead. She was a famous anthropologist in 1960s to 70s. Her work is profoundly recognized across the globe. In one dialogue, she was asked by her students that what does she recognize as the first sign of civilization? Her answer was not the potter's wheel or the needle or the fire which we discovered. Her answer was that first sign of civilization is the femur, the thigh bone, which was healed later. Strange. She moves ahead to explain the children. Next slide, please. She moves ahead to explain that why she considers that the broken thigh bone or the broken femur is the first sign of human civilization. Why? See, what happens in the animal world? If you break a leg, you are meant to die because you cannot walk, you cannot run, you cannot go for food, you cannot go for water. All you have to sit and wait until unless some other animal makes you their own food. You become prey. You become prey of the situation that your leg is broken. But with human being, what happened? There was one gentleman who might thousands and thousands of years ago, he might have broken his head, leg, and somebody might have stood beside him and waited till he heals. He protected him. I'll say this in Hindi a bit. सभ्यता की पहली निशानी जो मार्गरेट मीड ने अपने भाषण में हमें समझाया, अपने कार्यों में हमें समझाया कि जो टूटी हुई फीमर की हड्डी है, पैर की हड्डी है, और वो जब जुड़ गई, वो सभ्यता की पहली निशानी है, क्योंकि जो जानवरी की जो दुनिया होती है वहां पर अगर पैर टूट जाए तो आपको मरना होता है. आप खाने के लिए नहीं जा सकते हो, पानी नहीं ढूंढ सकते हो, इंतजार करना होता है कि कोई दूसरा जानवर आकर के आपको अपना भोजन बना ले. लेकिन जो पहला इंसान जिसके पैर टूटा होगा और पैर ठीक हुआ होगा, इसका मतलब ये है कोई ना कोई उसके बाजू में रुका होगा, इंतजार किया होगा, उसको सुरक्षा दिया होगा ताकि उसका पैर ठीक हो जाए. आई होप यू ऑल गेट इट. So she said, she continued to say that helping someone without expectation is the first sign of civilization. That is what is compassion. Let us sit back and think. My dear friends, in my 15 years of journey in social field, in social engagement, in community engagement, what I have realized, you can think with logic, you can make strategies, you can do planning, you can do everything. But if you don't have that compassion in your heart, you won't be able to do anything. You won't be able to make that difference. As Sri Krishna has also said, that if the foundation is compassion, agar samaj ki neev karuna ke aadhar par bane, and the branches are commitment and discipline, that society has to grow, has to develop. Okay, next slide, please. Now, my next slide will be for the students. There are many students out here. Okay, and I love to interact with young people. So children, we as students, what do we learn? We learn to take lesson. We learn to write exams. And when we learn to compete, competition comes with winning. Okay, so as this is a virtual class, virtual session, I cannot take you to exercises and all, but I'll try to explain you. We compete to win. Nobody competes here to fail. Everybody has to win. Win to achieve our dreams. Our dreams, our family's dreams, our society's dreams, everybody dreams for us. We need to achieve that. And to achieve that, we will have to win. And to win that, we will have to compete. And to compete that, we will have to write exams. To write exams, we will have to learn. Many of us love to learn, right? Many of us love to learn. But did we learn to love? Compassion talks about learning. How can we love? There are three mantras, my dear friends. One, to be empathetic. To empathize, to be grateful, and to forgive. Empathy is very, very, people can say that, yes, I am very empathetic. I have done so much charity. I am empathetic. I look forward, I go ahead and help people. I am empathetic. But there is a very silver line difference between being empathetic and helping others. Being empathetic is your personality trait. Whatever you do, whomsoever you talk, whether you are studying in school, you are in a family with friends, you go for an interview, you do business, whatever it is, how you reflect yourself is empathy. It is your personality trait. It is not an instinct. Empathy cannot come through instinct. Abhi kuch dekha, toh humne kuch kiya. That reflects your individual or your social sentiment. As Mr. Himanshu Rai yesterday was saying, very nicely, he described us about emotional intelligence, being empathetic, being grateful, being forgiveful is emotional intelligence. Now I come to being grateful. There are so many negative news these days, right? But are we thankful to what we have got around us? The speaker just before us, I forgot to write his name. He very nicely he explained about how to manage failure. Managing failure is important. Just drawing a link with managing failure, are we thankful to what we have achieved across our lives? What we are having across our lives? Do we acknowledge that? Acknowledging that every time is being grateful. At times we keep complaining, I don't have this, I don't have that, I don't have this, I don't have that. I should have a bigger mobile. I should have a bigger car, a bigger home. But are we grateful? Are we thankful to what we have got right now? While writing exam, I should have got more marks. But are we happy with the marks that we have received? I would take the example of the tribal way of living. We live in the tribal state, right? Jharkhand is a tribal state. And there is a lot to learn from these aboriginal people, the indigenous people, quote unquote, whom we call the Adivasis. They have a saying, jo prapt hai, wo paryapt hai. Okay. Means we have enough for our need, but we have less for our greed. So that is what is being grateful, to be thankful for what all things that we have with us right now. And finally, and the final step, the final mantra and the most important mantra is forgiveness. Forgiveness is very important. If we can forgive, if we can seek forgiveness, I would like to share my life experience, my dear friends. Almost 20 years back, we had a very sad incident at our home. My mother was assaulted very badly. Okay, she was having 80 stitches in her body. She is live now, but in those days, she was beaten up
by one of my neighbor, and she was having 80 stitches in her body. I was left with what? Just think, close your eyes and think. What would have happened if you are left with this kind of a situation? You are a young guy, your mother beaten up. One thing came into my heart, that was revenge. Somehow I will have to take revenge. And this quest of taking revenge drove me into anger, into fights, into quarrel. I had bad relation with all around, with my friends, my colleagues, my society, my family, because every next person was enemy to me. Who doesn't agree to me, he's an enemy. So that is how I became in those days. But one fine day, my mother said that you should learn to forgive. That is the most important. My mother, who was beaten up so badly with 80 stitches, doctors had said that she won't be alive, but thank God she is alive even today. But she said that you will have to forgive. Forgiving people is most important. That time it did not went into my heart. But slowly I started working on myself. What I realized that it is very easy to forgive others. It is not easy. It is not easy to forgive others, but you can forgive others. But it is difficult. It is almost impossible to forgive yourself. Khud ko shama karna sabse katin kaam hai. Friends, when we are into revenge, when we are into anger, we develop enmity. Be it small reason or a larger reason. Conflict does not start with very big issues. Conflict always starts with smaller issues, and it leads up to larger issues. So my dear friends, forgiveness is most important in our life. Why? When we forgive others, we become free. If we don't forgive, we become captive of our past. We become prisoner of our past. Agar hum shama nahi karenge, तो हम अपने भूतकाल में बंधे रहेंगे, हम अपने पास्ट में बंधे रहेंगे. एंड सी टुडे व्हाट हैपेंस आफ्टर सो मेनी टफ टाइम व्हेन आई रिकवर्ड, आई स्टार्टेड टू पार्टिसिपेट. दीज डेज आई एम इनवाइटेड बाय द डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन टू शेयर माय व्यूज, टू ट्रेन द पीपल हु आर इन द जेल, the prisoners, the remand home prisoners. So what was the foundation of my transformation? The foundation of my transformation was I learned to forgive. I learned to seek forgiveness. Ki bhai mujhe shama kar do. I learned to be grateful for what I have. I learned to empathize. Next slide, please. So I am talking about compassion so much, but as student, what will you get? My dear friends, as students, if you are kind enough in your heart, if you have learned to love, you will be having a different level of understanding others. You will understand more than anybody else if you have that kindness in your heart. If you have kindness, you have compassion, if you reflect with compassion, you will be more happy. After all, in life, there is nothing more than being happy. Agar hum khush hai, toh sab kuch hai. Right? We will be contented. And most important, we will be connected. We will be connected with our families, friends, and most important, we will be connected with ourselves. If you are kind enough, if we are compassionate, if we can empathize, we will not lose ourselves. And such kind of student, such kind of children, or such kind of individual who can empathize are likely to be more successful. A person, a hard-hearted person, seldom succeeds. because a person who is compassionate, a person who is kind, sees the problems. They has got very, very unique way of understanding problems, which is why you people who have kindness in your heart, who have compassion, who reflects with compassion, who helps friends, are likely to be more successful in life. I would again try to give example of our indigenous kind of living. I tell you, the Zulu tribe of Africa, they believe in Ubuntu culture. You might have heard about Ubuntu culture, many of you. People who won't have heard about Ubuntu culture, it says that I am because we are. मैं हूं क्योंकि हम सब हैं. इन उबुंटू कल्चर नोबडी फेल्स, नोबडी लूजेस, एवरीबडी लूजेस, सॉरी नोबडी लूजेस, नोबडी विंस, एवरीबडी विंस टुगेदर. दैट इज हाउ उबुंटू कल्चर इज. सो वी से दैट वी आर काइंड एनफ, बट डू वी केयर? We need to ask ourselves. Do we care? Kya hum parwah karte hain? If we care enough, we will share enough. If we share enough, we will have enough. Because this world has everything for our need, but this world has very less for our greed. My dear friends, we are human beings. We will always have needs in our life. But when you grow up, when you start to get your profession, and also the senior people, to them also, this world has enough for our need, but very little for our greed. Okay, next slide please. So you have we have this slide. There is one drop of water, okay, in a pool. It creates a drop of water, creates a ripple effect. Kindness is some kind of ripple effect. It creates a ripple effect. It is not stagnant, it will spread. If we have love in our heart, if we are compassionate enough, if we are kind enough, if we reflect every time with compassion, that will create ripple effect and it will be never ending. It will touch lives. How do we do that? I have written these are a few things which I have learned and which I have described in my way. That is, in our daily life, we many times face confrontation. We confront with our friends, we confront with our teachers, our brothers and sisters, our parents. Okay, the society is in confrontation, countries are in confrontation, conflicts, and finally war. So can we replace confrontation with carefrontation? Let us think. And if we can replace confrontation with carefrontation, definitely we will embrace happiness, and we will embrace happiness by forgiveness. Next slide please. So this is my proposal to all my friends. Let us practice, encourage and emphasis kindness. I have named it as peak. Why peak? Because the mountain has got a peak, and peak is the topmost point of a mountain. So for humanity, the peak of humanity is when we practice, encourage and emphasis on kindness. You see, there is one small little diagram. There is environment in the last column. Environment is base of everything.
On top, there is family and community. We are surrounded by our family and community. And in the center is the happiness, happiness in our heart. If we care enough, we can share enough. If we share enough, we will have enough. And we will be having happiness. Right? Next slide, please. So I have some tool. There are three tools. I give it to you. I hand over to you. Now it will be your responsibility to take care of the tools that I am sharing with you, my dear friends. Experience joy of giving. Joy of giving. We give something, right? You see in Jamshedpur, people who are from Jamshedpur, you can see wall of kindness in many schools and different places. Those was initiated by me in Jamshedpur, wall of kindness. So what do you do in wall of kindness? In wall of kindness, you donate things and you can take things from there. Means kindness is anonymous. If you give away something, you need not hold it back. If you take something, you need not ask who is giving, because the Almighty is there to give. Na? We are given from the Almighty. So you can create a kindness corner in your office, in your school, in your classroom, in your community, so that you can start practicing kindness. Next is kindness to mindfulness. When you start practicing kindness, you need to make it a habit. So I give you a challenge. I will give you a challenge. Practice kindness every day and note it down, write it down. The kindness can be anything. You can help somebody. You can forgive somebody. You can ask for forgiveness. You might have done some harm to somebody, or somebody might have pained by you. You can go and ask him for forgiveness. Even that is one act of kindness. You can thank somebody. While going to office, the driver, he opens the door for you and drives you to the office. Students who are going to schools and colleges, you are in your cab or in your auto, the driver takes you to the destination. The sabzi wala, the vegetable vendor, gives you sabzi and you brings it back home. Yes, you are paying them, but think, they are giving it to you, na? Even thanking them is so important. Have we ever thanked to our mother who cooks food every day? We take it for granted. It is her work. So kindness should reflect, must reflect from whatever we do. The housekeeping staff who collects those things, trash every day from our home. There was a movement asking to call those housekeeping staffs as safai wala and not kachra wala. Good thing. But have we ever thanked them? This is important. So I give you this challenge. Do a random or planned act of kindness every day. Note it down. And do it daily for 21 days. And see the difference. I am sure I have practiced this in my life. I have suggested this to many people, and people have practiced this in their lives, and they have come back and said, yes, that makes difference. I would request you all, practice kindness in whatever you do. You are studying, you are at home, anything. So finally, we become rich. See, there is a wallet. In wallet, you keep cash, your money. So this wallet will collect your happiness points. Anybody who are interested to practice PEAK can, I would request the next slide, please. Anybody in this team, in this group, interested to practice PEAK, to take this responsibility, because this is responsibility of globalization. This is not trade globalization. This is responsibility globalization. Okay, this addresses the entire globe. I would request you can have my phone number, my email address, and connect me anytime if you want to establish a peak center. Okay, I would love to have a couple of questions if I have got time.
Yes, sir, you please go ahead.
I had one question popped up. Abhishek, can you please read it out for me? I cannot see the chat box.
Just a second, sir. There was one question only. I wanted to practice it, sir, but initially, how should I start?
Okay. See, starting kindness, again, as I have told you, the last slide says that thoughts are living things. Soch jo hote hain, wo jeevit cheeze hain, wo jivant hote hain, wo that travel far, wo dur tak jate hain. First of all, you need to think what exactly you want to do. That's important. Okay, if you, and that instinct, I give you a 60-second challenge. Who asked that question? Who was that gentleman who asked that question?
Rotractor Rupa Devi.
Okay, Rotractor Rupa Ji. So I would just give you 60 seconds. In next 60 seconds, you think, you sit quiet and think. You sit quiet and think and what you want to do. And in that 60 second, please do that. You want to thank somebody? You want to seek some forgiveness? You want to extend your helping hand? But think for that 60 second, and this is only 60 second. And please, just after 60 second, do it, and please ring it back. Ring me back. So that is the beginning. The first step, that is most important. The moment you take that first step, the world is yours. The sky is the limit. That first step, we need to break that eggshell. Any more question, please?
Yeah, there is a question from Interactor Hafiz. Hafiz, you are unmuted. Please unmute yourself and ask your question.
Yes, please, Mr. Hafiz.
I have a question, not related to your speech, but a random question that how can I take Rotary as my career?
This is something which I am not the right person to answer.
Let me answer you this question. Just visit Rotary.org. There is a career option there, and you will find lot of career option who is presently open with Rotary world, right? So just visit the Rotary.org, you will get answer of your question.
Abhishek, I would like to add something. Yes. Just unmute Hamid.
Yeah, Hafiz. Hamid, you are unmuted.
Hamid, repeat your question. What do you want to say? Repeat your question.
I wanted to ask that how can I take Rotary as my career?
Why you want Rotary as your career? Rotary doesn't give you anything back. Your career should be something which pays you to make your both ends meet. Rotary is not a career. Rotary is add-on. First, you establish yourself in your life, do something fruitful for yourself, and then Rotary will invite you. Here is my invitation. First, excel in some way of life. Establish yourself. Be in a position. Your man and dhan. Only then Rotary will invite you, and then you will be more fruitful, more good for Rotary. Rotary can't be a career. It's not our career. First our family, then our business, and then Rotary. Be clear about it. Family, business, only then Rotary. Family, professor, only then Rotary. Right?
Rupa ji just now has come up with some experience. I would request Rupa ji, just express your thought, please, right now, up front.
Yeah, Rupa ji.
The world is yours. This time is yours, Rupa ji.
Yeah.
Please, up, unmute ho jaiye and express it.
Yes, sir. After this 60 seconds, I just wanted to thank one person in my life who's very supportive. And also, I wanted to ask sorry to the same person because I hurted him a lot by my words when I was in anger.
Please, Rupa ji, go ahead. If that person is in this team, then it is great. This will be the greatest moment. Please, okay. Rupa ji, go ahead.
So yes, in anger, I spoke, you know, very bad words, which I should not use. So I just wanted to ask a sorry for what I done. So, and also very thank you to that person. He's not here, but I just wanted to thank him because of him. I am here today. And thank you so much. And I just wanted to mention his name also. He is my friend, Dinesh Kumar, who is an advocate in High Court. Thank you so much, Dinesh Kumar. And also, I'm really sorry for hurting you. Thank you so much, sir, for your session. And I realized a lot in this 60 seconds. And I just wanted to practice it hereafter. And it makes me feel light after asking sorry or thank you here.
Yes. This is that spark. Don't let the spark die. Rupa ji, you are a great soul. You have opened eyes of all the participants out here, including me. Yes, change happens this way. Somebody has written a chat that kindness is meant to be weakness. Something like that. I don't exactly remember the chat, but something like that.
The question is, Salil sir, the question is, if someone misunderstood your kindness to badness, is it possible? The question is.
It is his understanding, his or her understanding.
Yes.
Why should I change? Because somebody else is understanding something. It is his or her understanding. I'll give you one example. I don't know who had asked that question. Just one example.
Anil,
harming somebody Rosemary. Is easy.
Rosemary
has healing somebody is easy. Which is the toughest task? Harming somebody or healing somebody? Which is the toughest task? Giving life to somebody? You will always say healing somebody is the toughest task. Because that needs more courage. The way Ms. Rupa ji has expressed, that needs courage. Now, if somebody thinks something about me, need not matter. We will focus the life's goal. We will lose focus of our life's goal. So, remain focused. Need not worry what who else is thinking what. Just remain focused. One day will come when the entire view towards you will definitely change, and that will be your own life. I'll give you one example. Once Mr. Gandhi, our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi, he was accused of, some corruption. He was accused of some corruption of few rupees of the fund. And everybody was questioning him that something is happening under your nose and you are not saying anything. Mr. Gandhi very calmly said that, see, if I say yes, you will have some meaning. If I say no, you will have some other meaning. So my life is my example. If you want to get something, some meaning, so please get that meaning from my life. This is very, very deep. Yeah. How we reflect in our life, how we address issues in our life, if we are having, that doesn't mean that somebody comes and beats me up, kills me up, and I don't defend myself. That is important. defending myself is important, but why should I break my head? Why should I get stressed because somebody is thinking something about me? Somebody is taking kindness as my weakness. No, kindness is not weakness. Kindness needs a lot of courage. In this COVID situation, most of the country were sitting at home. There were very few people with kind heart who were on the roads helping others. Right?
Yeah.
Yes, very few people. So Mahabharat teaches us that for with goodness you will have only 5 people, but with badness you will have 100 people. The Pandavas were 5 and the Kauravas were 100. So goodness is with only 5 people, badness with ultimately goodness wins. So my dear friend, be rest assured, if you are kind in your heart, no badness will ever affect you. You will ignore everything and move ahead.
Thank you very much.
Any other question? I would love to interact if the time permits at all.
Yeah, we have the time for another 5 minutes. Anybody is there with any questions? So we are delighted to have, this was an international student with us. She asked you a question. So it's good that we are connected, you know, all over the globe. So I request all interactors and Rotaractors, if you have something, any question, you can ask Salil ji. We have Sanjeev ji here.
Sonali Kar
ask anything related to your topics.
Anything.
Yeah. Let me answer Sonali Kars. Sonali, you there? You have asked whether those people deserve forgiveness who are doing big crimes across the world like the rapists or murderers. Two parallel line of thoughts run. Both the lines agree that they should be punished. But simply by punishing them till their end is not, it should not be the ultimatum. One line of thought goes like that. Another says, you know, they should be punished forever. Because what we call jail, by punishing, we put them in jail. What we call jail should be called reform centers. If someone is put there for some heinous crime and with passage of time, he shows internal change. He is changing. He has reformed. He is repenting for his crime. Then one line of thought says, They should be forgiven. They should get another shot in life. For example, Sonia Gandhi. She forgave Nalli, who was for a long time in jail. But ultimately, she said, I will forgive her. I have forgiven her for the heinous crime of blowing up her husband, our late Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi. There is nothing absolute in this direction. You can either forgive him after some time or at the outset, or you can ask, you know, these crimes are very heinous and they should be punished forever. It's up to you. It's up to a person concerned. Yes, Salil sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Sanjeev ji. That was wonderful. But still, I would like to just add a couple of, sentence to that. See, forgiving and punishing, two are different. Who punishes? The system, the judiciary is yes. There to punish, right? But if a person is convicted and punished, do we have that bitterness in our heart? If we don't have that bitterness in our heart, if we don't have that revenge in our heart, we are kind. Because a person who has committed a crime, he is so sorry. He is a sorry guy. He doesn't understand humanity. He doesn't understand so many things, which is why he is committing a crime. So, can we have a bit of kindness for him? Because the judiciary will do its work. If we are completely grossed with all those crimes around us, maybe on our life or somebody else's life, see how much negativity will we breed. Isn't it? So it is important to make ourselves free. So kindness is about making ourselves free, not about who is to be punished and who is not to be punished. Am I clear, my dear friend? Great.
There is one more question from Rosemary. Okay. What do I do to overcome my fear so that I will be successful in life? Rosemary, how you define success? Is it absolute at any given point? Just unmute Rosemary. Abhishek, just unmute Rosemary. Yeah, Rosemary, how you define success? Is it absolute? Is it like an iPhone? I want this iPhone. And that is over. Success is an ongoing process in your life. So, prepare yourself for every casualty in your life, every failure in your life, which will be the stepping stone for another success in your life. It's ongoing process. Why should you fear failure? And even then, if you don't have enough courage, then research famous persons like Thomas Edison, Michael Jordan, and see what they are saying. They are saying failures 100 times, 1,000 times, 9,000 times, 900 times, doesn't matter. You keep on trying, you keep on doing, focus on your goal, do the things differently, and you will achieve whatever you are defining as success in your life at this moment. After some time, after achieving this success, and after passage of some time, another success you will aspire for in your life. It's ongoing process, it's not absolute. So why fear it if it is not absolute?
Thank you, Sanjeev ji. I would like to add a sentence to Rosemary.
Welcome,
Rosemary,
sir.
What do you do? Are you a student, Rosemary?
Yes, sir. I'm a student.
Very good. Very good. Wonderful. So, right now, your exams, your assignments, your assessments, your marks, okay, your future plans, those are definitions of your success, right?
Yes,
but
sir.
So how much are you honest and kind enough on your efforts?
Well,
that will define your success. Okay. Yes. And I'll tell you, marks is not success. Getting a position is not success. Success is getting happiness. If I have done enough efforts, I was kind to myself, I was honest to myself, and I have got a certain marks. If I am happy with that, if I can justify my happiness, that is success.
Okay.
Yeah. Am I clear, Rosemary?
Yes, sir, you are clear. Thank you very much. I'm really happy and impressed. Thank you very much.
Very good. Very good. I'm so happy.
Thank you so much, Salil ji, Sanjeev ji, for your queries. I think they all are satisfied.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Sanjeev ji. Before we go for a vote of thanks, there is an important announcement for the second session.
I would, just a moment.
Yeah.
Let me thank the entire Rotary fraternity, the Raila team, Mrs. Meeta Parikh.
Yeah.
Who?
She's there with us.
Connected me, Mr. Dr. Amit Mukherjee, who called me up and said that you should do this, okay, who for the end support. I thank the moderator, and I also thank the speakers before me. Those were I-open. Thank you very much. And anybody, anytime, I am there for you all.
Thank you, Salil ji, for accepting my invitation and addressing this young mind. You were excellent in your thoughts, and your question answer session has given satisfaction to the children. I am very glad that we have chosen a right person for this session today. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you so much.
I would like to add, not only young mind, I also learned from you, Mr. Salil sir. Thank you.
Abhar, Abhar sir, Abhar.